I'm James Bronning, I'm the Artistic Director of Dundee Rep, and I'm the Director of Further Than the Furthest Thing by Zinnie Harris. It's a play that I've known for, well, since it was first done, which is in the late 90s, and I've seen a couple of productions of it and also done a workshop on it. It's a play that I love, partly because of it's so unusual as a play. It's about a very remote island, in a way the most remote place that human beings live, Tristan d'Acunha, which is in the South Atlantic, midway between South America and South Africa. And it's set on this tiny island, which has got a very, very small community of people whose roots go back 200 years or so. And in that sense, that's why the play's called Further Than the Furthest Thing. It's about as far as you can get, really, and still see humans. And the play examines what happens to this little community, which is very much connected to nature, the natural world, the sea, the sky, and the island is essentially a volcano. So into this little, if you like, quite Spartan paradise, there comes kind of the outside, the forces of the outside world, in the form of a businessman who wants to exploit some of the natural resources on the island, crawfish. I've loved this play for a long time, and I think its themes are major. They're about development, they're about the environment and human beings and the relationship of the two. They're about business, they're about capitalism and the effect of capitalism on people. They're about passion and love, about life and death. They're about massive themes, so that interests me, and telling stories that are informed by those themes. And also, as always with Dundee Rep and the ensemble, there are parts in the play which really work for certain actors in the company, and so the idea of certain actors taking certain roles is very exciting to me, because they just sit in those roles really comfortably. Using light, water, and creating an environment on the stage at the Rep, and making the stage of the Rep as big as it could possibly be, both width and depth. So we flood the stage, not literally flood it, but we have water there in which the play is done. But it is a play of two halves, because they leave the island at the interval. And so, again, without giving too much away, it's about how that changes and what that does to the atmosphere and to the temperature and to the human beings who are kind of removed from one place and taken somewhere completely different, physically different, geographically different, culturally very different.
Hello, my name is Neil Stenhartog. I'm the head of production at Dundee Rep Theatre, and my job is mainly to make the wishes and dreams of directors and designers come true. Directors and designers have meetings, decide on what type of set they want to use for the production, and then they come and see me with a model and tell me what they want, and then it's up to me to figure out how we can make this work. For our next show, Further Than the Furthest Things, we have, this is a model basically here, and what we are going to do is we're going to create a pool of water on the stage that these islands here sit inside of, and to start with, these will be submerged under the water, and then we drain the water away to expose them, and then during the interval we drain all the water away to be recycled for future use when we flood the place again. Now, the main thing we had to consider was the weight of the water, because obviously this is a fairly large pool. It's 11 metres deep that way and 10 metres across, which equates to quite a lot of water, which is quite a lot of weight. But we had it checked by structural engineers and our stage is up to carrying the weight. We're talking about 29,000 litres of water, just about. So that equates to about 29 tonnes of weight, but we are assured that the stage will take that. Basically, what we're going to try and do is bring in the water from here. Behind this wall is actually our paint shop where all the workings will be. We will then fill the pool, the audience come in, and then, as I say, we then drain the pool to expose these platforms, and then during the interval we drain the entire pool. It's quite a task, but it seems to be going well. After all the calculations and costings, we are quite confident that it's going to work.